I do think in Christian circles we have a very difficult time recognizing emotion, and a lot of times we see emotion as this. I need to keep that under control, right? Because the fruit of the Spirit in Galatians 5 is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, gentleness, faithfulness, goodness, and self-control. Like, okay, we have to remain self-controlled. We have to be kind. We have to be, you know, gentle and peaceful and all these things. But the reality is that not feeling emotion is not self-control. For me to sit in a movie theater and to watch a movie and to try to fight and hold back tears that I'm experiencing from that movie is not self-control. Self-control is my ability to enter into those tears, my ability to embrace that emotion, to embrace the grieving, to embrace the fear. And there's nothing wrong with that at all. In fact, God says, in your anger, do not sin. He doesn't say, do not be angry. He says, in your anger, do not sin. So in other words, as we talk about in our children's book, What Am I Feeling? A feeling is just a feeling. It's not in charge of you. However, over time, we have to realize that spiritual and emotional maturity go hand in hand. You cannot be spiritually mature while remaining emotionally immature, because the fruit of the Spirit, love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, gentleness, faithfulness, goodness, and self-control are the fruit of the Spirit. They're not the fruits of the Spirit. So in other words, not character traits, and they're not just standalones. They all go together. So in other words, what is it to be faithful to a friend, to be faithful to someone who has hurt me, to be faithful to someone who's hurting themselves, their behaviors are hurting themselves, for me to be able to be faithful to that friend and speak truth to that friend is gonna require me courage. It might be fearful for me to step into that, but to be gentle in that, to not fly off the handle when someone has wronged me, to be able to maintain that all in this context of feeling all these emotions requires presence. It requires the ability to know what I'm feeling and why I'm feeling that way. So to neglect anger because we think it's more appropriate, more socially appropriate in certain circles, or to neglect a certain feeling because it might make us look weak, would be to look at David in the book of Psalms and say, well, he was a crazy nut because he felt all these things. No, David knew that when Paul wrote, be anxious for nothing, but go to in prayer and supplication, make your request be known to God, take that to God. And I think Psalms is a voyeuristic look into David's journal of what it is to truly emote, to truly be able to have feelings, to voice those to God, and to do it to a God who can handle it. And so if people around you can't handle it, that's the human response to not being able to handle it. But we love a God who can handle our emotion, and which is why Paul, I think, gives us that framework in Philippians 4 to go to him, because that becomes then the foundation for us to live out the fruit of the Spirit.